This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the nature of responsibility centers. There are several different types of responsibility centers, and we're going to talk about each of those. But first, we'll talk about why companies do use responsibility centers, and I have more on this in a different video. So this is just a quick summary before we get into the three different types of responsibility centers. So companies do use responsibility centers to evaluate performance and to establish responsibility. And they often divide their operations into what are called segments or divisions or subunits. And those segments are also called responsibility centers. So again, I have a separate video that talks about why companies divide out into segments, but now we're going to get into these different, what they're called, these different types of segments, so and how they're evaluated. So responsibility centers can be based on things like sales regions. It could be that we have a sales group over in Southeast Asia and over in West Europe and over in the northeastern part of the United States. It could be anywhere, and so we could break our responsibility centers out by sales region. It could be that we're going to do this, break out these areas, these centers by product lines. So perhaps we are Home Depot and we have a lumber yard or lumber product line. We have a gardening product line. We have carpeting. We have appliances. So we could break out those responsibility centers by product lines, depending on the company, or it could be by services offered. Maybe we are an accounting firm and we offer tax services and auditing services and other consulting services. So we break out our responsibility centers by services offered. So it depends on the company, but as companies get larger, they tend to break out pieces of the company into these different responsibility centers. Organizations establish responsibility centers to, one reason is, to hold managers responsible for assets, revenues, and costs that they can control. And it might be some subset of that. Managers don't always have control over all three. It could be that managers only have control over costs, which is the example you see in the very bottom bullet point. For example, if I'm a production manager, then I'm responsible for the production of our products and the costs that are associated with that production. I really don't have any control over revenues or over the assets, the machinery, for example, that we put into place. That's usually upper management that has control over that. I'm really being evaluated based on the costs. So it depends. That's one example. If I'm looking at a department that's only responsible for costs, then I'm going to be evaluated based on those costs because that's the only thing that I can control as a manager. I can't control revenues and assets. There are three different types of responsibility centers, and you see them here. The first is a cost center, and then the profit center, and then the investment center. So think about the three items that I talked about on the previous slide: assets, revenues, and costs. With a cost center, the segment is responsible only for costs. And I gave you an example on the previous slide of a production department. Here, there's an example as well. It's a different example. If I am the human resource department within a company, then I'm responsible solely for costs. The human resource department typically is responsible for hiring employees, perhaps training employees, evaluating employees, those types of things. But the human resource department does not typically have control over revenue or investments. So that would be an example of a cost center. Production department is also a cost center, as I mentioned on the previous slide. The next type of responsibility center is the profit center. And the profit center is a segment that's responsible, think income statement, for costs and for revenues. And again, that's what you would expect to see in the income statement, but not for investment in assets. So a profit center might be, and we'll see this on the next slide, it could be an individual retail store that where the manager is responsible for everything that goes on within that retail store except for investment in assets. And so the manager or group of managers might be responsible for the revenues and costs associated with that retail store. Same thing could be said about a fast food restaurant. Maybe there's an individual store for a fast food restaurant, for example, a McDonald's, and it's part of a larger chain, but the manager is responsible only for that one store and the costs and revenues associated with that one fast food restaurant. That would be a profit center. And then the third type of responsibility center is an investment center. And this is a segment where the manager or group of managers are responsible for all three: costs, revenues, and investments. And it really varies. It depends on the company. And again, if we're managerial accountants within the company, we'll know. We'll know which managers are responsible for what. But an example here would be Disney theme park. If I'm part of a group of managers, or maybe I'm the only manager that oversees a Disney theme park, I'm potentially responsible for the investments that are made in perhaps the rides that they're used in that theme park. I'm responsible for the revenues that are generated from that theme park and the costs that are incurred to run that theme park. If that's the case, then we're looking at an investment center. And this slide simply emphasizes the point that I made on the previous slide. It gives you three different examples. There's an example here for a cost center, and the human resource department tends to be a pretty good example for that. There are many others, but that tends to be a pretty good example. The human resource department is typically responsible only for the costs that are incurred within that department, so that would be a cost center. Profit center is what you see in the middle here, and I mentioned before a fast food restaurant is an example of that. Assuming that the manager is not responsible for investment in assets for that particular restaurant, but is responsible for revenues and costs, then we're looking at a profit center. And lastly, a theme park is an example of an investment center because typically the manager, a group of managers, are responsible for not only the revenues that are generated from that park and the costs associated with running it, but also the investments in long-term assets related to that theme park. So why is this important? We need to identify the type of responsibility center so that we can then start to talk about measures that are used to evaluate the managers that run each of those responsibility centers. And we will talk about that in a separate lecture.